Welcome home.
With the announcement of Starfield and The Elder Scrolls 6 at E3 2018, a lot of people have assumed that somehow means that both games are releasing sometime sooner rather than later. However, that doesn't seem to be the case at all, at least according to Pete Hines. During Fallout 76's recent press events, Bethesda's marketing head Pete Hines spoke with Eurogamer, and when asked about when we'll hear more about Starfield and The Elder Scrolls 6, Hines said, "A while from now, and a really long while from now, respectively." Hines further explained, saying the following: "Actually, I should not be quite so dismissive of the question, which is to say, the time frame for Bethesda Game Studios titles has not changed at all." The most interesting bit from the interview is his explanation for why the projects were revealed so early, that is, if they're following the same time frame as previous releases. According to Pete Hines, these games were announced to alleviate concerns of Bethesda Game Studios abandoning single-player projects, which, if you're unaware, both Starfield and The Elder Scrolls 6 will apparently be fully single player. So here is what Pete Hines had to say in detail. "What changed was our desire to lay out a roadmap of those titles. Not like, hey, they're going to be putting out a game every 9 months. No, it still takes them years in between projects, but because we were doing something so different on Fallout 76, taking that franchise in such a different direction, doing an online game that doesn't look like something you'd expect from BGS, we thought it was important to say, hey, new IP, single player, sci-fi thing coming. Hey, we are doing The Elder Scrolls 6 after that." So that people didn't start spinning off on, like, that's the end of single-player games from Bethesda Game Studios. Timeframe-wise, it would still be about as long as you'd expect when you look at Fallout 3 to Skyrim to Fallout 4 to Fallout 76. It's still going to be those periods of time. That hasn't changed. Or at least I don't think it will change from that based on what I know. Which, to break that down for you, it means the following. Fallout 3 and Skyrim were 3 years apart, which was 2008 to 2011. Skyrim and Fallout 4 were 4 years apart, which was 2011 and 2015. Fallout 4 and Fallout 76 are also 3 years apart, which is 2015 to 2018. So based off of Pete saying it will be like those three time frames, Starfield will be coming around 3 to 4 years after Fallout 76, and The Elder Scrolls 6 will be coming another 3 to 4 years after that, which means Starfield will be releasing in 2021 to 2022, and The Elder Scrolls 6 won't be releasing until 2024 to 2025. That is, if development is smooth sailing for both games. And what further backs up Starfield not coming for some time is the recent announcement from Pete Hines that Fallout 76 mod support won't be coming until November 2019 at the soonest, which is over a year away. If you want to know more about that topic, I've left a link to my video down in the pinned comment below. Let me know your thoughts on Starfield not releasing for another 3 to 4 years, and The Elder Scrolls 6 looking to be over 6 to 7 years away. It's a really long wait, if you ask me, even for Starfield. But The Elder Scrolls 6, damn, that's gonna be painful. Anyways, be sure to hit the bell icon to stay updated on the latest and greatest Bethesda news, discussions, and speculation. But that's it for this video. If you enjoyed, please smack that like button down below and subscribe to join the good fights if you haven't already. It'd be super greatly appreciated, as always. And until next time, this is Epoxy, signing off.